I wish you could answer me, Mom. Mr. Atkins said he'd fail me if I was even a minute late again.
Insidious Chapter 3 is actually a prequel. It's set a few years before the first film. It tells the story of a teenage girl named Quinn who has recently lost her mother.
Mom? It's a really hard time in her life being 17, about to graduate high school, trying to find the right college, except I don't have my mom there to talk to.
The father is not really coping. He's arguing with his daughter. He doesn't understand her.
What are you doing?
I'm taking a photo.
You know, nobody cares what you're having for breakfast. Will you just go get your brother ready for school, please?
She just really wants some advice with her mother, and she's so desperate to talk to her that she goes to visit a psychic, Lise.
You've tried to contact your mother on your own, haven't you?
Yeah.
Lee found ways to investigate the early part of my life, which still leads us into what they've already learned about Elise.
We start off the film with her in a pretty bad place. She's in a pretty depressed state.
She's like very downtrodden. Her husband has committed suicide.
But she reluctantly helps this girl out, and that kickstarts the story in motion.
And that's when I get involved with some bad spirits.
What's happening to me?
I had a vision of you. You were in the dark. I've been to that place. When you go there, things come back with you.
She's sort of clutched onto by a series of demons.
Give her back. It's feeding on her soul. There are all these sort of elements that invite you in, and then they just wring you out.
It's so scary and intense.
It's a crazy, scary movie.
We want people to be absolutely terrified.
I'll be waiting in the dark when the pain finally kills you.